Today we are going to Meland Club, which is a kids soccer play place here in China. They have them all over China. There's like a bunch of, in Korea they call them kids cafes. I don't know what we call them. That's wrong.
I don't know.
Kids play places? We don't have a name for it. This is supposed to be the biggest one in Penang, so we're gonna be spending the day here. Show you a little bit of what that's like.
On outside staff, keep looking at the old and the young. At the same time, for your safety, please don't go too close to the lake. Do not cross the fence. Do not allow children to ride on the fence.
It's like a play area outside. So we're in, it's called 1903, which is like the famous shopping mall in Kunming, or a famous, I should say. But this building is like specifically all kid stuff. Outside there's like a little amusement park. Inside it's all kids play areas. There's candy, kids stores, like wow. Very catered to children. We've been here before, but this is our first time going to this soft play place with Amelie now that she's maybe old enough. Seen your friend a whole day or two. Daddy, there's baby. There she goes. Oh, well, that makes sense. I was too young. I mean, if she's gonna do it herself.
Mind your head.
Oh. I didn't realize there was you. I think it's supposed to like rain balls down when it's ready. Stop. Wow.
Where do you want to go? Going this way?
We're gonna go to that room.
Emily, you wanna go over there? Okay, let's go.
Meland.
Pretty incredible. Better than anything we have in the UK.
So in the US we're talking about how we have a bunch of like tubes and slides and ball pits, but parents can't go with really. Like I would go to those places and then get stuck, and then not stuck, I would be playing and my mom would yell for me and I'm just like la la la, I can't hear you. But here it's really nice because it's pretty comfortable for parents as well to also run around and play with their kids.
Yeah, this has been thought out very well. And you can only really do this in China. I guess in like the UK, it'd just be too expensive to do anything like this. You'd never get your money back. But in China, you can.
Yeah.
Benefits of China.
I guess, I don't know how much are play places back home. Here we paid $350 per family. $350 is like $50. maybe. So $350, it's $50 more or less, and that's including two adults and one child. You do have to pay for each parent, which is also kind of annoying, but I guess now I can see why, because parents can also play around too, maybe.
And you can get your money's worth.
Yeah!
Yeah, you can also jump around.
With a fine selection of seafood for 30 quid.
He'll do something.
Emily, what do you think? Wow. Look at all this.
Watching me, like looking all around?
No. We were playing over there for a while and she didn't want to leave. Even now she likes this vantage point.
She likes this area. All right, so I lost Ashley and Amelie for a brief minute, but turns out they had the high vantage point. Right?
Yeah, it can be quite easy to lose your kids in the air. So you gotta stay on top of them.
I know, I saw the ceiling, and I was like,
where are they?
Where is it?
Yeah, so they have an area, I think you pay extra to get your hair done and get dressed up like a princess. We will not be doing that, but for older kids, that could be nice. We're on a mission to go find the cafe.
Turns out that Ashley gave Owen and I, or the ladies gave us a bit of a break. Owen and I are going to an American diner while Ashley's and the ladies stay here with the daughters.
We've never heard of Green Dan before as a restaurant. I keep saying it's a Western restaurant, but I've never seen this in Canada or in the US.
And Owen says he's never seen this in England either, so we think it's just a Chinese brand, but still, they're burgers, so.
Slippers and stuff at the front. Ha, I have these slippers at home. This. And then I can get her a smallish cup. Thank you. just like, why am I doing this?
Hello.
Don't worry, it's only the princess dressing room.